Welcome to the course Compiler Design. Our next lecture is on finite automata. So here we will discuss about various concepts related to finite automata. The first one is non-deterministic finite automata, then transition tables, acceptance of input string by automata, then deterministic finite automata. So all these concepts we already studied in the course formal language and automata theory in the previous semester. So we will review again the finite automaton concepts which are used to recognize tokens. For that purpose, finite automata used. So now you can recall once finite automaton with respect to lexical analysis. So now finite automaton is used in lexical analysis, one of the application of finite automata. Here we shall now discuss how Lex turns its input program to a lexical analyzer. So at the heart of the transition is the formalism known as a finite automaton. These are essentially graphs like transition diagrams with a few differences. Finite automata are recognizers, we know. They simply say yes or no. That means accept or not accept about each possible input string. Finite automata comes in two flavors or two categories. First one is non-deterministic finite automaton. Then second one is deterministic finite automaton, abbreviated as NFA and DFA. So now non-deterministic finite automaton have no restrictions on the labels of their edges. A symbol can label several edges out of the same state, and even with empty, that is epsilon, the empty string is a possible label. No restrictions on non-deterministic, only on deterministic finite automaton, we have restrictions. For more details about the non-deterministic finite automaton, you can watch the YouTube lecture, so which was covered in the previous semester in the course formal language and automata theory. Then coming to deterministic finite automaton, how for each state and for each symbol of its input alphabet, exactly one edge with that symbol leaving that state. That means from a state on one input symbol, it has only one next state. Whereas in non-deterministic finite automata, from a state on one input symbol, it has more than one next state with same input symbol, same state. So this is called as NFA. This is called as deterministic finite automata. Then for more details about deterministic finite automata, you have to watch the lecture video, so which was covered in the previous semester course, formal language and automata theory. So then coming to some of the examples of this finite automata with the acceptance. So both deterministic finite automata and non-deterministic finite automata, which are capable of recognizing the same languages, is one of the advantages of these two. In fact, these languages are exactly the same languages called the regular languages that regular expression can describe. So both deterministic finite automata, non-deterministic finite automata accepts or recognizes regular languages that regular expression can describe. Then recall once the definition of these two automatons. First, see the non-deterministic finite automaton, which can be defined as a quintuple or a five-tuple denoted by M equal to Q sigma delta Q naught F, where capital Q is finite or non-empty set of states or internal state, whereas sigma is input alphabet, then Q naught is initial state or start state, and Q naught is in Q, that is Q naught belongs to Q. In any automaton, initial or start state is only one. Then capital F is set of final or accepting state, which is subset of Q, F is subset of Q. Then delta is transition function or moving function, also called as mapping function. Using this function, the next state can be determined. Then the transition function is a mapping function, which can be defined as mapping from Q cross sigma to 2 power Q. That is, delta is mapping from Q cross sigma to 2 power Q, where 2 power Q is power set of Q, so which is the set of all states of Q. This is the formal or mathematical or tuple definition of non-deterministic finite automaton. Then deterministic finite automaton is also same, only the restrictions it has to follow. So we can represent either an NFA or DFA by a transition graph where the nodes are states and the labeled edges represent the transition function. There is an edge labeled with A from state S to state T if and only if T is one of the next states for the state S and input A. This graph is very much like a transition diagram, except the same symbol can label edges from one state to several different states. And an edge may be labeled by epsilon, which is the empty string, instead of or in addition to symbols from the input alphabet. Then let us see one example of non-deterministic finite automaton transition diagram. So example, transition graph for a non-deterministic finite automaton, which recognizes the language of regular expression A plus B whole closure A BB is shown in figure. So the following automaton is for the regular expression A plus B whole closure concatenation with A BB. So now here we have taken the first starting state named as zero, labeled with the phrase start by drawing an arrow, which denotes the starting state. So A plus B whole closure can be written as a loop, wherever plus is there, that is replaced with comma. This is nothing but A plus B whole closure. Then here by excluding epsilons directly, we are writing NFA here for simpler forms. Then for concatenation with A, B, B. Concatenation means you can take a sequence. So then now for this concatenation with first A, in between by introducing a new state labeled with A, then again introduce another state named as 2. Then the next label is the next symbol, that is B. Again introduce another new state, name it as 3. Then the last symbol is B. Now the last state can be designated as final state, which can be represented using double circle. Now you can see whenever you can concatenate all these, what you will get here, this is loop means here you will get A plus B whole closure, then concatenation with A, then again concatenation with B, again concatenation with B. Now you see here we got our regular expression, whatever the given regular expression. So this is the example of non-deterministic finite automata. You can test why not is a deterministic finite automata. How can you say it is non-deterministic? Here let us see. From state 0, see on input A, it is going to state 0. Same again on input A, it is going to state 1. So that's why this is NFA. In deterministic finite automata, this is not allowed. From a state with same input symbol, it has only one next state. Even it doesn't allow null also. That's why this is example of non-deterministic finite automata. Then similarly, we can construct a transition table also. We can also represent an NFA by a transition table whose rows correspond to states and whose columns correspond to input symbols, including null. Then the entry for a given state and input is the value of the transition function applied to those arguments. If the transition function has no information about that state input pair, delta, so no information, that means no transition, then simply we can put pi in the table for this pair on state q on input a. So some cases we'll use simply blank or hyphen, but generally we'll put pi also. Now let us see for the previous example, the transition table. The transition table for the NFA given below. So same NFA is considered. Now the transition table. Here we will take rows and column combinations. So here the row headings are states. Then column headings are input symbols, which can be taken from sigma, then including null also. But null is not in sigma. That is not input alphabet. So that is separate empty string. So for this also, we can define transition. From state Q naught, see on input A, it is going to Q naught and it is going to, zero and it is going to one. So now we can combine both states 0, 1. Here don't confuse 0, 1, 2, 3 are state names, whereas A, B are input symbols. Then from state 0 on input B, it is going to zero itself, therefore zero. Then from state 0 with epsilon, you don't have any transition labeled with epsilon. That's why we have made it as phi. Then from state 1, on input A, you don't have transition, so it is phi. Then on input B, it is going to state 2. Therefore, the next state is 2. Then from state 1 with the epsilon, you don't have transition. Why you have taken epsilon means because this is NFA, there is possibility to have epsilon also. That's why we have taken epsilon. Whereas DFA, you can't consider epsilon as the column heading in the transition table. Then from state 2 on input A, you don't have transition, so it is phi. From state 2 on input B, it is going to state 3, therefore it is 3. Then from state 2 on epsilon, you don't have transition. From state 3 on input AB, you don't have transition, so both are phi. Then on epsilon also, there is no transition, so this is phi. Now this is the transition table for the given NFA. So now let us see acceptance of input string by automata. Same concept, whatever we discussed in the course, formal language and automata theory. Same concept we are using here. So acceptance of input string by finite automata, it may be NFA or DFA, whatever. A string W is said to be accepted by a NFA M equal to Q sigma delta Q naught F. The condition is if delta cap of Q naught comma W equal to P, where delta cap is the extended delta definition of NFA. So whenever you will get a state P or set of states, here for some P belongs to F. From the set P, at least one state is in a final state, then we can say the string W is accepted by this NFA. So this is basically the acceptability of a string by the final state. So as for the extended delta definition, these two rules are used while checking the acceptance of input string by automata. The first condition is delta cap of Q naught comma epsilon. So from a state, initial state with empty input, so here there is no change of state, simply you will get same state. So you will get Q naught only, where Q naught belongs to the set capital Q, set of states. Then second rule, delta cap of Q naught comma, a string W followed by an input symbol A. This can be expanded like this by using normal delta. Delta of delta cap of Q naught comma W comma A. Here W and A are separated. After simplification of this by repeating this rule, finally, if you will get a set of states denoted as capital P, so where W belongs to sigma closure, the string, then Q naught belongs to capital Q, then A belongs to sigma input alphabet, then P belongs to Q. So by using this rule 1 and 2 during acceptance of strings by automata, so we will verify. Now let us check the same example what we described above. Check the string AABB is accepted or not by the given NFA. So the method one here, what you have to do, simply by taking the given input string with extended delta definition, delta cap of Q naught comma AABB. So here first what you have to do, the leftmost input symbol we will take, then two symbols we will take, then three symbols we will take, then four symbols, like that. First input symbol A, leftmost symbol you can take, you can apply this extended delta definition. So delta cap of Q naught comma A, using the above extended delta rule, this can be expanded by using delta. Delta of delta cap of Q naught comma, we are separating A. Whenever A is separated, then what will be there here? Null, epsilon comma A. You know this value. So delta cap of Q naught comma epsilon equal to Q naught using the above rule one. So you can substitute this value as Q naught. So this entire value is Q naught comma, now the input is A. Now delta of Q naught on A by the given NFA, what is the delta of Q naught on A? It is going to Q naught and it is going to Q1. Therefore, Q naught Q1. This is the result of the first step. Next step, you can take the two input symbols from left to right. So now second step. So here we will take two input symbols, delta cap of Q naught comma AA. So again, you can expand this one by separating the rightmost A. This can be written as a delta of delta cap of Q naught comma A comma A. We know this value in the previous step. What is this value? Q naught Q1. Substitute this value. Now this will become delta of Q naught comma Q1 comma input is A. Again, apply union rule here. This can be written as delta of Q naught comma A union delta of Q1 comma A. So then substitute these transitions by seeing the transition diagram or table. So here the first one is Q naught on A equal to Q naught comma Q1. Q naught comma Q1, then Q naught on B, Q1 on A. Q1 on input A, you don't have transition. Simply you can take pi. Now by simplifying this one, you will get Q0, Q1 only. So this is the second step value. Third step, then you can take three input symbols. The third symbol is B is added here. Again, you can expand this one. Like that, you have to continue. Now delta cap of Q0, comma AABB. Rightmost symbol, every time you have to separate. So then this can be written as delta of delta cap of Q0, comma A, comma B. You know this value in the previous step. Delta cap of Q0, comma AA equal to Q0, comma Q1. This value is substituted. The next input symbol is B. Again, you can apply union rule with the delta. Delta of Q0, comma B union, delta of Q1, comma B. Now Q0 on B from the transition diagram, its value is Q0. Then delta of Q1 on B, its transition is Q2. Then by combining these two, you will get Q0, comma Q2. Then you can take the entire string. Why? Because of latter only one symbol is missed. That is one more B. Now delta cap of Q0, comma AABB. Now last B, rightmost B, you can separate. Now this can be written as delta of delta cap of Q0, comma AABB. You know this value in the previous step. What is this value? Q0, comma Q2. The input is B. Now you can substitute here. Delta of Q0, comma Q2, comma B. And by applying union rule, delta of Q0 on B, union delta of Q2 on B. By substituting these transitions, delta of Q0 on B, you will get Q0. Then delta of Q2 on B, you will get Q3. Then by combining this, Q0, Q3. Now we can see, let us assume this has capital P. This is the last step. So in this, at least some P belongs to F. Here you can see we got Q3. Q3 is the final state. You can see the transition diagram. Here Q3 is the final state. Therefore, finally, we got a state in F. Therefore, the conclusion, the string AABB is accepted by the given non-deterministic finite automaton. Like that, we can check any given string, whether this is accepted or not by the given automaton. So now we have another method also. So another method, nothing but by using proliferation, a sequence of moves made for the string to accept. So check the string AAA is accepted or not by the given NFA. Accept the long ways. This is the long ways. A closure plus BB closure. This is another example actually. So here we will see the method two. We need to check AAA whether this is accepted or not. Same example, you can do it as practice problem using method one also. So here first you can start with the initial state Q0. So first symbol, we need to derive A. The possibilities are in which path, if you will consider, if you will get A. So from Q0 to Q1 with epsilon, finally epsilon is avoided. Why? Because this is null. Whenever you can go to Q1 state, here you will get A. Then if you can go to Q3, you won't get A. Compulsory, the possibility is you have to go through Q1 only. That's why Q0 to Q1, the first path labeled by epsilon. Then from Q1, compulsory, our input is A. So anyway, here the transition is also A. So with A, it is going to Q2. So then from Q2, again, it contains A as loop. So if you want any number of A's, you can take. So now you want one more A from Q2 to Q2, take A. Then again, we need one more A, Q2 to Q2 A. Now you can combine in the sequence, the input symbols, what are the symbols occurred by excluding null, A. Now you can see. So we derived the string, but in this sequence, the last one, Q2, that should be a final state here. Q2 belongs to F also. Here Q2 is final state, which is represented with the double circle. Therefore, we derived the string, then we got the final state. Therefore, the string AA is accepted. Like that, by writing the sequence of paths also, we can check acceptance. The string AAA is accepted because of the path deriving the string AAA and reaching to the final state. Note that epsilon disappear in a concatenation. So the label of the path is AAA. This is the method two. Previous problem also you can do using this method two. Then coming to deterministic finite automaton. So this is the special case of NFA where there are no moves on input epsilon. And for each state S yes, and an input symbol A, there exists exactly one edge out of S labeled A. So if you are using a transition table to represent a DFA, then each entry is a single state. We may therefore represent this state without the braces. Why? Because only one next state that we use to form sets. So now deterministic finite automaton, see some differences between NFA and DFA. While the NFA is an abstract representation of an algorithm to recognize the strings of a certain languages, then the DFA is simple concrete algorithm for recognizing strings. So it is fortunate indeed that every regular expression and every NFA can be converted to a DFA accepting the same language, because it is the DFA that we really implement or simulate when building a lexical analyzer. So then here a simple algorithm for simulating a DFA is shown here. The algorithm name is called as simulating a deterministic finite automaton. The input is an input string X terminated by end of file using the character EOF. Then a DFA named as D with the start state assume S naught, accepting state assume capital F, and transition function assume it has moved. Then output is the answer yes if D accepts X, otherwise no. So output of any automaton is yes or no, accept or not accept. Then the method is apply the algorithm shown below to the input string X. The function move of S comma C use the state to which there is an edge from state yes on input C. The function next character returns the next character of the input string X. So here move and next character, two functions are used. Now let us see the skeletal algorithm. First S equal to S naught, then C equal to next character. This is the method we are calling. While C not equal to end of file, then S equal to move S comma C, then C equal to next character. Then if S is in final state, then it returns yes. Otherwise it returns no, else no. This is the simple simulation of DFA. So then let us see one example of DFA accepting the language, the regular expression A plus B whole closure ABB. In the previous example, for the same regular expression, we discussed the NFA. For that, the equivalent DFA is constructed. So how to construct this DFA for the given NFA? We know the procedures, NFA to DFA conversions. Even if we have epsilon, NFA with epsilon to DFA also. Using those methods, you can construct the DFA. Again, we will use the subset method also that we will discuss later. Now here, the given input string AB, ABB. This DFA enters the sequence of states to get the string Q0, Q1, Q2, Q1, Q2, Q3, and finally it returns as yes. Now coming to the summary of this lecture, here we discussed about first introduction to finite automata, then we discussed about non-deterministic finite automata, then transition table, then one example, then acceptance of input string by this automaton, then deterministic finite automaton. So next lecture we'll discuss about from regular expression to automata. Suppose if we have a regular expression, conversion of regular expression to first we have a NFA or NFA with epsilon, then direct DFA. So these three conversions we'll discuss in the next lecture. This also we covered in our previous course, formal language and automata theory. So for this lecture, the reference AHO to section 3.6, whatever we covered in this lecture. Now I stop here. We'll meet you in the next class with the new topic.